About that,
the
my friend.
Should have been
because
there,
it's on CBS.
Uh-huh.
Here's the thing. I will actually be doing a special Sunday night episode of The Late Show after the game that night. We got Conan O'Brien's going to be here. Mm-hmm. Our good friend Steve Carell. Steve Carell is going to make a special appearance.
James.
Mr. James Taylor will be performing that night. And
James,
a whole
man.
Bunch of other surprises. A whole bunch of surprises. You got to tune. You got to play to win.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, just, you know, it's my way of pitching in because I love this network. And hopefully, I'm trying to get some people to tune into the Super Bowl that night.
Yeah.
I'm driving tune in to the game.
Driving.
Of course, people around here, they're very excited for the game. It feels like every one of my staff wishes they could ask the players just one question. So I decided to let them do that. This is The Late Show's Just One Question Super Bowl edition.
So what was your first thought when you found out you were going to the Super Bowl?
My first thought was, I hope we get a lot of tickets because I have a big family.
If you win the Super Bowl, are you going to Disneyland?
Nah, man, I'm banned for life because I got too excited on a Pirates of the Caribbean ride. I tried to fight the skeletons because they wasn't about to do my boy Jack Sparrow like that.
Do you have any nicknames for your coach?
Sure.
Like what?
We call him Coach. You know his real name isn't Coach, right?
Whoa, that makes sense.
Hey, throw me the ball. I'm open.
Are you sure?
Yeah, come on. Hit me.
All right.
Whoa!
Get it. Money. Whoa!
Hey, how much can you bench?
You mean lifting weights or feeding birds while you sit in a park bench? Because I can feed birds in the park all day without getting tired. They're like nature's friends.
Do you ever get sick of people asking you to take selfies with them?
Not really. It's actually a nice way to.
Great, let's do this.
Do you have any plans for your life after football?
Yeah, after football, I'm gonna play baseball. And after baseball, I'm gonna play Hamlet.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio, a fellow of infinite jest, of most excellent fancy.
Would you like to be in the Hall of Fame?
Yes, but not for football, for poker.
Hi, football player. You know, I've always wondered, how do you decide the numbers on your jerseys?
That's simple. It's based on the number of cupcakes I can eat under a minute.
That's what I thought.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles and by opposing, end them.
Are you worried some woman will only love you because you're a famous muscular athlete?
It's fine with me.
Let me ask you this. Are there any product endorsements you've had to turn down?
Just one, Endicott's puppy meth. You know, Endicott's puppy meth. When you want to give meth to your puppy.
Now I'm alone. Oh, what a rogue and peasant slave am I. But in a fiction, in a dream of passion, could force his soul to his own conceit.
What is the hardest part of your job?
Trying to figure out which end of the football is the front and which end is the back. I mean, look at this thing.
This is the front.
What makes that the front?
Because this is the back.
Congratulations. You're bringing Los Angeles to the Super Bowl for the first time since 1980. So I've got to ask you, who's going to win The Bachelor this year?
Well, look, Hannah G is doing way better than Hannah B. I mean, she got the first impression role, so I mean, she's sitting pretty. But Colton didn't take her on any dates last week. Plus, there's always Cassie, so I say it's anyone's game, I don't know.
What a piece of work is man. How noble in reason, how infinite in faculty. In form and moving, how express and admirable in action. How like an angel in apprehension, how like a god. The rest is silence. Oh, oh.